Hi, I'm Matt Ogburn at the Smithsonian Environmental Research Center. On this metal frame in the background is an instrument called a multi-beam sonar, or a Denson for short. Using sound, it works kind of like a video camera underwater. Here in the Road River, there's sort of a mud bottom with sticks and leaves on the bottom. Other places we'll study, we'll use this in seagrass beds, coral reefs, and other types of systems. And then we can compare across all those different places and types of habitats what fish are doing and how active they are as predators.
What we need is a way of measuring fish where we can get who's there, how abundant they are, what they're doing, and we can do that in all kinds of habitats. So one of the things that we're exploring is this double beam sonar technique called Denson, which is essentially a very high resolution fish finder. It's possible to use this in turbid estuaries where you can't see underwater. It's also possible to use it in clear water. And so we are now testing out ways of calibrating that method against other methods that have been used, like the diver surveys and video surveys, so that we can actually compare, really for the first time, the abundance and diversity of these fish communities across very different kinds of ecosystems.
Hi, my name's Michael Goodison. I'm a technician at the Smithsonian Environmental Research Center in Edgewater, Maryland. I'm down here specifically using our Denson sonar device to study fish abundances in different habitats or across different habitats, such as coral reefs, mangrove environments, seagrass beds, and even just big flat sandy areas. One striking difference between these two areas, be it the coral reef here in Belize or the Chesapeake Bay back in Maryland or Virginia, is water clarity. The water here is crystal clear. You can see upwards of 80 feet away from you. The water is so clear. Whereas in the Chesapeake Bay in Maryland specifically, where we use this technology most of the time, you're lucky to be able to see 80 centimeters. The Denson could possibly be one technique you can use across all places. Historically, here in Belize, fish surveys are done by scuba diving or snorkeling, whereas fish sampling in more turbid waters is generally done with seine nets or trawl nets or gill nets, which can actually sometimes be very destructive.